Top of the morning. Welcome to the Wavy Wayne Office Hours Q&A today. We're doing a Q&A today. Drop into the chat. Put your questions down there. And let's chop it up. Hit the question button. I want to try this because I ain't tried this yet. But if y'all got questions today, let's do this Q&A style. Good morning. I see y'all piling in. I appreciate y'all coming through this morning. Is it Friday yet? Is it Friday? Let me check my watch. I never am too sure. Oh, it says Friday. It says Friday, man. It say that it's Friday. You dropped your blunt guts on my flow. That's a fact, man. Cuz be disrespectful with the blunt guts all over the all over the studio. They got the weed crumbs on the table, blunt guts all over the flow, man. Top of the morning to y'all. I'm literally watching your videos right now. That's what's up. Just take a pause with me. Any questions you got? Let's use this Q&A feature. They got a little question thing you can hit. I'm taking questions through there. I want to see how that worked out. I never tried it. Top of the morning, y'all. Please, let's try that out. I know y'all like asking questions directly in the chat, but if we post those questions up, I think you can like post it and then everybody can see. That just might be a little cooler. I never tried this. Let me see something, man. So I'm live. This is my baby girl. I didn't know you could do that. All right, let me do that. Stop sharing. That's kind of tight. I could choose different. I just turned my mic off, turned it back on. Let me see. I'm going to show y'all look.
Now it's just break this, down, bro.
Yep, just start breaking it down. And like, hella slop.
This is behind the scenes. Behind the scenes of the video from yesterday.
That's how the frame is kind of tight.
So just drop it right in front of you.
So bring it back. Because we ain't going to really see you drop it. This is
straight.
Just put it down in front. There you go.
Y'all don't know we get here to do a straight production, man.
Start. Come on.
If y'all got questions, drop them in the Q&A.
Just start letting shit fall, though. Make some shit fall.
That ain't gonna start falling until you got it. That shit.
Yeah,
you gotta have
that one grow. Well, fucking then. Just open it up and drop all the goods on the floor.
Right. Yo, we can start. I'm like, put Buddy out in that corner jersey, dude.
We rolling.
Y'all getting the behind the scenes of the joints, man. Put your questions in using the Q&A feature. Use the Q&A feature. We got two questions over there. Drop them over there. I don't know where it says. It's at the bottom of the screen somewhere. It's the one with a question mark.
Drop them all? Mm-hmm.
Now
let's
just break it down,
bro.
Yep, just start breaking it down.
Nah, man, that was funny. That's just a little behind the scenes footage of how we be producing the little TikToks and the reels for y'all. I'm about to go over here. Let's go to the first Q&A. You can receive questions when badges are on, but you can't show them on screen. They weak as hell. Soon as I do that, look, it's cool. Don't worry about it. Just put y'all questions in the chat. Because as soon as I just went to the little question thing, and it say you can receive questions when badges are on, but you can't show them on screen. And ain't nobody even bought no badges, man. But it's cool. I see the questions anyway. Jay Kavosky 901 says, you going to run a special on the certification course soon? Yes and no. I say yes, because if you try to find this certification course anywhere else with the level of attention that I am offering and all of the insight that I'm bringing to it, you're not going to find it at this price. You're not going to find this course at this price point. So I think it's a hell of a deal already. So it's already a hell of a deal. And I say no, because no, it's already a hell of a deal. Oh, man. Nah, man. Like, listen, I understand it's not a little bit of money, but this is what you call investing in yourself, right? You have to invest in yourself. I'm building this. I created this so y'all wouldn't have to go and spend $40,000, $50,000, $100,000 at a university to get this type of information. That's why I make my YouTube channel. After I went over $100,000 in debt to learn what I know, I went straight to YouTube and taught y'all everything I know, right? And then I created other programs at a much, much cheaper cost to bring y'all everything that I know, and also bring my my mentors along for the ride. So discount, nah, but the price probably do go up though. Real talk. The inflation is at 6% right now, okay? Everything is going up in the world. Nothing is going down. Everything is only going up. So you either get in right now or it probably be higher in the next few months. Okay, I'm just being honest. Because inflation, everything is costing me more. Everything is costing everybody more. Okay. That's all I'm saying. I'm still reading these questions that y'all put over here. And then I'm gonna get into the chat. I'm having a lag. Type Mix Studio say I'm having a lag on my external monitor and plugins are not responding accurately to playback. How can I fix it? I'm having a lag on my external monitor and plugins are not responding accurately to playback, okay? I don't know what you mean by the plugins. This whole question is a little bit confusing to me, and I need to get more information to give you an accurate answer. But one thing that you having a problem with your computer. Your CPU might not be able to keep up with the demands that you are placing on it. I think that might be part of the problem, is that the CPU and the computer just can't keep up. Maybe your hard drive is even slow, okay? So if you're using Pro Tools, go to the setup menu. I'm gonna say this slow so you make sure you listen. If you're using Pro Tools, go to the setup menu, choose playback engine. At the bottom of it, they have a little section called disk cache, okay? Make sure that's set to normal. If it's not set to normal already, but if it is set to normal already and you're still getting these problems, then increase the cache size to about 50% or whatever the available RAM is that you have on your computer, okay? Again, go to setup menu, playback engine. If it's already set to, if it's not set to normal, set it to normal and try that. That'll dynamically allocate the amount of RAM that's needed throughout the session. If it is already set to normal and it's giving you problems, then I would say boost that up to about 50% or whatever the available cache is on your system, okay? RAM is on your system. What AAE error warned me? This I do not know, but who does know? It depends on what it means, what it is, and what happens when you get it. What are you doing when you're getting this AAE error? But one thing that I always do, anytime I'm working in Pro Tools and I get an error code, I go to place that code in Google, okay? AAE error one. If you place that in Google, that'll lead you to a forum that can give you a lot of information from some other people who have had similar issues. And they'll help you to resolve that. Okay? But if you're constantly getting it, what I would do is start a new session and then use import session data to bring the tracks from the old session that's giving you errors over into your new session. I would start a whole brand new blank session and then use import session data to bring those tracks over into the new session. Let's go. Say Wavy, the best music engineer teacher I've ever had, and we still learning. That's a fact. Shout out to the Wavy Sills Elite. I like effects too. Okay, I don't know what that means. Let me see. I think we got more questions. What you working on today? Trip Wild says, I'm working on a mix that I started yesterday. I'm going to finish that up today. I'm going to put a few YouTube videos out. Got a couple of meetings that I need to have today, some administrative work. And that's it. So I got a YouTube video where I'm mixing a song. and show y'all how I'm using Isotope Ozone 9 to help me with that mix. It's pretty dope, actually. I actually like Isotope Ozone 9 a lot. So that video is going out later this afternoon. I'm also working on another mix that's actually fire. It's a fire mix. I was working on it yesterday, ran out of time, so I'm back today. Fresh ears, fresh perspective. We're gonna finish that up. Let me go see what other questions we got. Oh, we got a badge in the building. Now I'm activated. How do you maintain a steady flow of work and clients? I'm making a living off engineering, but trying to have consistent everyday work. Any tips? Also, what about filing taxes? All right, so to stay always working is definitely a challenge when you're a freelancer, because in our industry, we have peaks and valleys. We got times to where everything is in high demand, and then we got other times that seem like nobody wants to work, right? So with that being known, one thing you definitely gotta do is that when you are, like, plan for the future, and when you are getting those times when the work is plentiful and the money is plentiful, conserve, right? Conserve the money that you're making and plan for the future in that day, like, kind of set yourself a budget and work off of that, so that when the tracks slow up a little bit, you still have enough money in your reserves to sustain yourself, pay your bills, and stuff like that. So that's one of the first things I learned freelancing, is that, hey, man, sometimes, like, I might make $10,000 one month when I was starting out, and then for the next 3 months, I might make $500 a month each month. So, you know, that's how the work come and go when you are freelancing. So you got to know how to balance your own budget and not ball out when you get a big job and stuff, and know how to just put a little bit away for a rainy day. But as far as getting clients to come in consistently, one thing you could do is I would try this. When you have a client, maybe offer them a discount. Like, let's say they come in and book a 4-hour session. At the end of that session, I'm like, you know what? I'll give you 15% off your next session if you book it right now and leave a deposit. And also finding clients that are serious about what they do. Finding clients that are serious about what they do, because they always going to need to record, right? So that is something that, if you get, you know, there's a lot of clients that just want to come and record real quick, feel like a rapper for the weekend. And there's other people who taking it seriously, like it's they calling, right? You want to connect with as many people as it's they calling to be in the studio. And then when you connect with them like that, they'll keep coming back. They'll always have projects. They'll always have work for you. Also, we got to think about institutions as well. As audio engineers, I think we kind of neglect that institutions need audio services as well. What I mean by that is schools, churches, businesses, right? And they have budgets, and they are more consistent with utilizing these services. So I was talking a while back about podcasting, right? So as a recording studio, your calendar might not be full all the time with people who want to come in and make songs. But maybe you got 3 or 4 businesses that you work with on a monthly basis to produce their podcast, right? Maybe there's a church that you go and run live sound at on the weekend, and that's every weekend, right? Or a couple of churches that you do that at. So maybe there's a school that needs an after-school program where you can go in and teach them how to do recording and mixing or making beats for the kids, right? Now, I'm telling you, this is all stuff that I've done to fill my calendar and keep my calendar full. So I know that it's definitely possible, and the work is out there. Who bought a badge? Let me see, man. Jay Robles. Shout out to my Wavy Seals Elite, man. Always coming through. I like some. I don't know why I keep going to that. What's your favorite EQ plugin lately? Fab Filter Pro Q3 is, you know, that's my go-to. Anyone else have AAE1 problems? I don't know. I had a similar issue to that. Also, depending on what equipment you're using, because Scarlett puts more processing on your CPU than anything. Let me go down to the most recent comments. What's good, big bro? What's up? Wow, I never thought about partnerships. Absolutely. And when it comes to, like, podcasts, especially for businesses and stuff, we gotta stop thinking about the one-offs, right? I know we get off into a lot of work, hourly work, and thinking about doing this one little gig, one thing. But you can come to a business and propose them to say, you know, look, let's get a 6-month contract to do your podcast, right? And that 6-month contract going to be a whole lot more money in a lump sum than it would be if you just do the thing one time. And again, these businesses, churches, any business, really. Shoot, we talked, somebody asked about taxes. The tax people, they need a podcast too. They need a podcast too. Everybody need a podcast. Everybody need to record. The radio station, anybody with a business who needs to record a commercial for their radio, for radio or whatever. You could open yourself up to not just be taking on music jobs, but any type of audio related job. Use your skill set in a diverse set of ways, okay? We're going to work together soon. That's a bet. Bro, I am a bad person for not wanting to work with people who are bad at rapping. Am I bad? No, I wouldn't say you're a bad person, not for that. But I would say as an engineer, always just try to find the silver lining in what it is that you're doing, right? You're there to provide a service first and foremost. Then do that. If that's what you're there for, is to provide the service, not an opinion. And it might be harder. So, you know, I love what I do, but sometimes working with some clients remind me that it is a job. Some clients that you work with are going to remind you that this is a job. Sometimes you're going to be doing stuff like, I can't believe I'm getting paid to do this. And then other times you're going to be like, they not paying me enough to do this. So it's a balance between that and just you know, respect everybody's ambition, if anything, man. If they took the time out and exposed themselves to come and be vulnerable in your studio, I think you got to respect that. You got to treat that with a certain amount of delicacy. So, yeah, man, I wouldn't say you're a bad person. Just try to look at the person as a whole person and not just a rapper. And there's something inside of them they trying to express. It might not be coming out right now, but maybe you got something that you can help them with. Maybe you can guide them along their journey and help them to get a little bit better. Do you partner with sounds? I don't know what that means. And good. Okay. Good morning. Top of the morning. We got one bad supporter out here, my man Jay Robles. It's Friday. I know y'all got y'all check. Y'all engineers, what y'all talking about? We don't get a check. I live for them. High quality clients. Somebody at the door. Let me see, man. Who at the door? It's the fuzz.
It's the leak.
It's the elite. Hear that. Yeah, man. What's popping, man? Y'all, man, hold up. Let me bring my cast on, man. We got the cast of No Smoking in the Studio. Were they hating on us? Oh, with the monetization? I seen it. They ain't let us back in. It's cool though. I thought you'd add me something. Nah, I know I'm good though. Yeah, y'all. I appreciate y'all been sharing though. Y'all been sharing a lot of stuff. Literally watch all your videos since I started self-recording. Cooking up. Let me go back over to the questions. I know some people had questions. How do we weed out the young guys that be low quality clients and want to come in and waste time and write and then not prepared, LOL, even though they had their beat ready? That kind of go back to what I was just saying on my last little comment, man. For one, I don't really care if a client comes into the studio unprepared, if they didn't write anything, if they didn't pick out a beat. I work hourly though, you know what I'm saying? I charge them hourly and I get paid before we start doing the work. So whatever, I want you to leave here with something that you can be proud of, but if you don't, like, it's not because of me. I was ready. I had the mic set up when you walked in. Everything is ready to go. If you want to take, you know, 2 or 3 out of your 4-hour session, to write and smoke and chill and do whatever, call some girls over, do whatever you want to do. Just, you know that you're on the clock. The clock is running. And the clock don't start once your inspiration comes. The clock starts once you, at the time that we said we're going to start. So that's how I deal with that, man. Like, don't try not to take stuff too seriously. And what allows you to have that freedom is just by having rules and having your expectations laid out in the beginning. So once the client knows, hey, you got to put 50% down to even book with me to get on my calendar. Once you arrive, I'm going to need that other 50%. Once they know that. All right. Once they know that, then it's whatever from there. Hold on one second, y'all. What up? We live over on tickety-tickety-tickety-tickety-tock, too. There we go. I bet. This is Inception. This is live Inception. No, this is really live Inception. Live meet live. Live meet live. Okay, what else? Y'all got more questions? I like answering y'all questions. Let me see. Y'all ain't really got too many questions. How do you make that? Okay. What's up? All one ENT say raise your prices. That's another, hey, I'm glad you said that, because that is definitely, raising your prices is definitely one way to weed out people who are not serious. And that's something that I did, man. And my the list of people that I had to work with started to minimize. So yeah, if you're getting a lot of people that you feel like they're coming in, they're wasting your time, they're not serious, you're probably not charging enough. Because once you're charging enough, they ain't going to be able to waste your time. We got Young Guru in the building. Shout out to Young Guru, man. Can I tap you in? Let me see if I can get you in here real quick, man. Come join me. But that's a big plus. A big fact is to raise your prices, man. Orca Baby say, pick me. Let me get you in, Orca Baby. We live over on TikTok, too. If y'all not following me on TikTok, make sure y'all do that. This too, a couple of times that's good to know when to raise your prices. A, when your schedule is booked, when you fully booked, when you fully booked, what's popping? Okay, let me run two things down real quick. When your schedule is fully booked, that means you can raise your prices, all right? You're in enough demand. And then also, shit. I forgot my other point. Well, what's good, Orca?
What's up, bro? Excuse my horrible quality camera. I'm using my mom's phone, but
it's all good, bro.
I be making beats, bro, and I be trying to network with people. I be trying to send out all beats.
Okay. What you mean? You trying? Or you not?
I am. I'm trying to get my first placement.
Okay.
And I just send them out. But I'm fired, bro. Like, you, can I play you a beat?
Let me hear something, bro.
All right, bet.
Yes, sir. What's up to all my people over here on TikTok? Where I'm from? I'm from St. Louis. You see the big STL on the cap? Come on, quick.
Are you in St. Louis, bro?
Man, maybe. Where you at?
I'm in the zoo, bro.
You in St. Louis?
Yeah.
What part? What part of St. Louis you from?
I'm in the city on the north side.
I know. No. I'm just playing. You for real? That's what's up, though. I'm in U City, fam.
Are you in U City? I was just down there last night. All right, I'm going to play this beat. What type of beat?
Play your heat. I think we got Young Guru right. Had tapped in with us, man. I think you know. But... Y'all, man. I think of that. Thank you.
one more. How about one more?
Travis, those leads are crazy. That's what's up. Look, man, so you getting confirmation right now that people like what you're doing, okay? All you got to do is keep doing what you're doing, keep finding ways to reach more people with it. One way is doing stuff like this, man, getting out, talking to people, playing your music, being prepared. You was ready for this opportunity just now. So, look, man, and I'm sure, let me see, and you right here in the town, you in St. Louis, Orca Baby, make sure y'all go follow him. If y'all, all the people that was putting the fire up, I know some of y'all is artists. Make sure y'all go follow them. You got 813 calling.
Right on, bro. I appreciate it, bro.
No doubt. Orca, a couple people saying DM them. So go ahead, comments and get busy.
I'm going to DM you, y'all.
All right.
Appreciate it.
Yes, sir. All right,
bro. Head up.
Head up, bread up. Oh, man. Y'all be talking too smooth. Can I send you a song and have you play it in your studio? I'm at work right now, but I just want to show. I don't want to pull it up. Honestly, you're going to make me work, man. Let me go over to TikTok real quick. St. Louis is a crazy place. I got some clients and good friends from there. That's a fact. I'm on TikTok right now. We live over here. Make sure if you're on Instagram, I want y'all to make sure y'all do follow me on TikTok too. JC was popping. JTVO was popping. Wayne was popping. Keep going, fam. Let me see. I don't know how to let me see. Somebody was on TikTok asking me if they can get in and play their song. I don't think that I can
They gotta send a
request. You gotta send me, yeah. If you wanna, you gotta send me a request. Over on Tiggity Tot. Cruise NYN. You won't regret it. I know, man. I know. I don't think I will. Let me see. Yeah, y'all gonna have to send me a request over here if y'all wanna. Okay, hold up. Add guest. Oh, we ain't got zero requests. So send me a request. All right, let me see. Signal chain. Who else wanna jump in here? Who got questions too? We doing Q&A. We listening to y'all music. We networking. We buying badges. Oh, we buying badges today? We buying badges today? We got tips? Thanks for the love, Orca Baby. No doubt. L.A. breadwinner, La breadwinner. I don't know if it's La breadwinner or L.A. breadwinner, but, yo, I appreciate you always popping up, showing support. It does not go unnoticed, man. Keep going, fam. Don't stop. That's a fact. All one. Shout out my bad supporters, man. J. Robles, all one ENT. You look different when you leave a comment when you got a badge. Yeah, man. So, I don't know. Y'all light on the questions today. Y'all just in here. Y'all popping in to see what's going on. It's cool. Like I said, though, I got a mix that I need to be getting working on today, dropping a YouTube video today. Oh, we got a funny TikTok today. If y'all thought that yesterday was funny, wait till you see what we dropping today. Make sure y'all sharing. I like TikTok. I look better on TikTok than I do on Instagram. I'm looking on the Instagram over here, Cap. Wavy Gang, what are good mastering monitors? Dude, the same thing that make good mastering monitors will be the same thing that make good mixing monitors, I believe. Something that that tells you the truth. It's a good quality reference, you know? A good quality reference, not overhyping anything. Is it best to record in loud or low? That's a good question. Neither. You want to be right in a happy place. But if I had to answer that, it is better to record it in a little bit too quiet than a little too loud, because once you reach that clipping, you can't go back from that. We can always increase the gain, right? And nowadays, we're not worried about noise floor or nothing like that when it comes to our audio interfaces. They're pretty quiet, so we're not worried about too much noise floor. So we can always increase the gain. So I would say error on the side of too quiet than being too loud and risk clipping. Okay, you don't want to. That's what we don't want. We can't really go back from that. Any advice for sync license opportunities? I'm going to have to get my wife Lydia on here. She is the sync license queen. She's been synced on all kind of commercials, television shows, and everything like that. I'm going to see if she want to join us. Let me see. She probably at home with the baby. I'm about to invite her, though. If she come on, then y'all might get a little lesson in sync licensing. Matter of fact, let me invite her. Can I invite her over here? Friends. You can't search. I ain't got that many friends, huh? You right about that. Yeah, but if Lydia jumped in, do you accept Atmos for mixing? Not yet, but I'm working on building up my Atmos studio. We coming alive. This the year for that. Negative 12 to negative 18 dB, usually solid. Yeah, somewhere around there. I like to be a little hotter, around, you know, negative 10, negative 8, negative 6. But just Miss Caesar's unable to join. She don't wanna join us, man. I got told my KRKs were raggedy and not good for mastering. Shake my head from a client. They probably would, you know, listen, KRKs are not the best, most true, transparent monitor. The KRKs definitely color the sound. I've used KRKs for years though. The thing about them is that you just got to learn them, just like anything else. You got to know those monitors. You got to listen to music. Any studio monitors that y'all have, you have to listen to regular, professionally mixed and mastered music on them constantly, daily. Use them to just listen and enjoy music. This way your ears get attuned to what those monitors sound like, how they react in your room. All of that is key. All of that is key. So even though I got a pair of KRKs still, I keep them around. They were my first ever studio monitors. The way I did good work on them is because I listened to all music through them all the time. So regardless of what the monitors was doing, I knew what music was supposed to sound like coming through them. You know, I knew, like, when I listened to a Dr. Dre song, I knew what it sounded like coming through those monitors. So if I can get my stuff to sound close to that, then I'm in the ballpark, okay? Now, you definitely want to get something, though, that's a little bit more transparent, though, if you're going to be doing mastering. And before y'all do mastering, y'all need to be mastering mixing, mastering recording, and you know, not try to do everything all at once. I don't have live access, but would love for you to hear my beat. Sorry. go over to Instagram. I'm Wayne.Wave on Instagram too. Best engineer service on YouTube. I appreciate that. How do I send you music? Oh, that no smoking reel on your page. Funny. Thank you. Y'all want to see the star of that? Here go the star. Oh man! Oh my God! Dropping the blunt guts in the street. He fucking that shit. Oh, Let me see. I ain't getting no requests. I don't know. I'm still learning TikTok and all that. I know that it's different than Instagram. I appreciate y'all for sending likes and all of that. Let me see. Man, when I listen, people use auto-tune on YouTube. It sounds different. But even when I put the same setting, the sound is very dull and bad robotic. What am I missing? Is it a common mistake? With it sounding dull, that don't got nothing to do with the auto-tune, right? The robotic, yeah, that means you probably got your retune speed up too high. For one, you want to make sure that your key is right. Make sure you're in the right key. And also make sure that your input is set correctly so that it's not, it start off on soprano. You're probably more of a tenor. You know, most people are, you know, that's kind of the middle of the road on there. So I would move it down, make sure that your input selection is correct, make sure that the key selection is correct. I think AutoTune Pro is definitely the best version of AutoTune that's out right now. The other versions of AutoTune are also great, though. You know, so you can definitely get a good sound. But if it's sounding dull, that's because of other things that you're doing in the mix. Maybe you need to use some EQ before you go into the AutoTune to filter out frequencies that you don't need in that vocal. Maybe even add a little high frequency sheen on top of it. But dullness is not going to come from the auto tune. Yamahas versus Adams. Yamahas all, I mean, Adam all day. My bad, I was almost, I was mistaken. Adams all day. Adams all day. Now, I have the Yamaha HS5s on my desk right now. As my B set of monitors, I swapped them out, you know, with different sets of monitors all the time. I do like the HS5s, though. There is something about that monitor that I like, you know. When I'm working on the HS5s, I like to, like, turn them up loud and turn the sub off. And be able to, like, get that mix sounding good on those small monitors by themselves, and then that usually translates everywhere else. Is Yamaha better than KRK? I would say they are more transparent. They're going to result in better mixes. Should I get the Pro Tools certificate if I don't know jack nothing about Pro Tools, learning from ground zero? Absolutely. This is exactly the course for you. Whether you never opened Pro Tools before or you've used it for 20 years, we're going to take you from the beginning. Back when Pro Tools was first created, you're going to learn everything about the menu systems. You're going to learn all the different operations, the controls, every button, every maneuver in Pro Tools. So if you've never opened it up, you don't know jack squat, the Pro Tools certification course is for you. You can go to the story right now, swipe up to enroll, or go right over to the link in bio. Same thing for y'all over on TikTok. Would you ever make collab videos with artists for promo? For sure. Any thoughts on using samples? Use them. Yeah, I think the samples are, everybody uses samples. Everybody's using samples. Kick drum samples, 808 samples, vocal samples. Everybody's using samples, man. Probably the wrong key. What's the difference between Humanizer and Flex Tune? That's a good question. So the Humanizer is just going to make it seem a little bit more natural. Change from one note to the other. And we're talking about AutoTune Pro settings here. So if anybody is not clear, so somebody asked what's the difference between the Humanizer and the Flex Tune. So the Humanizer control is just going to make the transition from note to note feel a little bit more natural. Okay. Feel a little bit more natural on that transition from note to note. The Flex Tune, basically, what flex tune is kind of like the sustain, and the way I'm feeling it, it's like a sustain, right? To where if I start off, right, to where we might fix the note right at the attack of it, but if they like running on with that note and there's some vibrato and stuff, and they're close enough to what the actual note is, then the flex tune will actually, the more you got it turned up, the more that we're going to just flex it and let more of that natural note come in after we do the initial correction, right? So that's my understanding of the differences there. Yeah. It's more like a sustain. How long are we holding that correction? And the humanized is more how smooth the transition is from no change to no change, okay? I started writing and playing guitar at 10 years old. When did you find your love for music? Probably about that same time. When I was in the second grade, I started in Sunrise Conservatory, where I was, learning to read music, learning to play percussion, and from there, I just been kind of locked in ever since. Thank you. Stay wavy. Try to use Melodyne. It sounds more natural. What is your list of favorite mics for recording vocals? A list of favorite mics for recording vocals. I like the Shure SM7B. I love that on aggressive vocals. I love my Mojave MA300. I love my Lawson L47. What other mics do I use often? Yeah, those are some of my favorite. I got a Vanguard V13 that I also like too. But yeah, I got a lot of different mics. For vocals though, L47 is typically my go-to. Oh yeah, I got the Stam Audio SA47 too. I love the U47 style for vocals for most times. If the client's a little more aggressive, I might go with a SM7B. But those are some of my favorites for sure. Seven Pills joint and start following me. Thank you. Orion Rose bought a badge. Thank you. How can an engineer expand his or her brand? So how can you expand your brand as an engineer? By doing great work with more clients. Our field is definitely a lot of word of mouth. Also requesting that your the people that you work with, your clients, make sure they share your stuff and tag you, man. Tag me. That's a, like, look, you tagging the photographer, you tagging the videographer, you ain't tag your engineer though. Damn, bro, you got to get to make them put some respect on what you do. Make them next time they in the studio turning up with their friends, hit the bypass on the auto tune real quick. And then they make everybody realize your value. And make everybody realize your value when you bypass the auto tune while they're in that thing. Oh, hey, yo, shorty, listen to this. Play it without the auto tune. Oh, yeah, my man, let me tighten you up real quick. But to expand your brand, though, kind of going back to what I was saying before, is think outside of music, right? As audio engineers, we can engineer any type of audio. That could be podcasts. It could be Foley post-production work. It could be recording stuff for commercials, for film, television, radio. And that's how you expand your brand, is by actually expanding the amount of services that you offer, right? So we have a skill set, but we don't have to be locked into the studio to do what we do. You can get out in the field and do recording, right? If you're good at what you do, you could even teach. You could even teach what you're doing. So that's all I'm saying. You got to expand your offering. Can people send you stems for you to mix? I don't like to mix on stems. I prefer to rather have the full multi-tracks. The difference is, like, stems is like when you got the drums. And yeah, you bounce down all the drums, and then you just got the drums, and you got the melodies, and then you just got the melody. I don't want to mix like that. I want to mix the whole song. So I prefer that you send me a full multi-track. Does it apply to Logic? Everything applies to Logic. Any DAW. I didn't give any DAW-specific advice, I don't think. For R&B vocals, would you use Melodyne before Auto-Tune during your mix process? Man, look, I like to work with singers who can sing. So I would prefer not to use any of that. Tuning vocals too, though, is a whole nother job, man. Tuning vocals is actually a producer's job. Don't get me talking. Tuning vocals is the producer's job. So maybe I need to start charging. If I got a Melodyne and all that, you probably getting hit with an extra fee. Because tuning vocals is the job of the producer. Why I say tuning vocals is the job of the producer? Because that's production work. To me, the job of the engineer is to make sure that we bring everything together sonically. We do handle the technical aspect. Tuning vocals, like what we doing, we getting stuff in key, we moving notes around. That same thing as like if I go in and start changing the arrangement of the piano, I'm changing the arrangement of the vocals. I'm doing production. That's why. So that's my take on it. Now, do I do it when I'm working on a mix? Yes, because I want the best possible outcome for the mix, right? We can't just send them back a crappy mix with the untuned vocals and be like, you know, that ain't really my job to tune your vocals. But ideally, you know, it's so much better to work with people that can sing, man. Oh, my God. J Money, Studio 1-5, a professional duo. What? I don't know what that means. Melodyne works great with every genre and is very transparent. Yes, Melodyne is great. Melodyne is very great. I also like the auto-tune graph mode. So if you're working with Auto-Tune Pro, you can use the graph mode and get in there and get a whole lot more surgical with the tuning of the vocals. What are your opinions of the Yamaha HS7s? I think they're pretty dope. I like those. I got the HS5s. I've had the HS8s. Wavy, appreciate you, my guy. Plus 48. I always appreciate you. Love that name. What's some good producer engineer school? The Wavy Wayne School. The Wavy Wayne School. You can get some of your lessons free on YouTube. You can take it further by signing up for the Wavy Seals Elite. And also enrolling in my Pro Tools certification course. That'll teach you everything you need to know to be a proficient user of Pro Tools. Wavy Seals Elite is a dope community where you get to actually learn from my mentors. You can get your mixes reviewed if you and with actionable advice. You know, so I'm not just gonna like, oh, this sounds good, it sounds bad. It's gonna give you some actionable advice on that you can take to improve your mixes. We got a monthly mixes mix competition inside the Wavy Seals Elite. We got exclusive master classes, all kind of it's a whole wealth of knowledge that you just don't get from watching me on YouTube. I share a whole hell of a lot on YouTube. I never hold back, but I definitely I give to my people, my Wavy Seals Elite. Do you use any mic gain gear? Absolutely, I use the Cloud Lifter with my SM7B. Unless I'm running through like my Focusrite ISA 428, where I can change the impedance, you can put that into the high impedance mode. And you don't need a Cloud Lifter. But if you're going straight into something like Apollo, then you definitely need a Cloud Lifter. See if it works now. I do follow you. I don't know what you're talking about. Facts. I think engineers should get a percent of royalties of songs they mix. Your thoughts? I've had this conversation with y'all before. I definitely think that mixing is production. I think that mixing is production. When you are adding reverb or delays, you are producing a song when you're making these decisions. So it's really up to what you negotiate. Some engineers do get a percentage. But everything is about what you negotiate. Just because you think you should, if you don't say nothing about it, ain't nobody just gonna offer you nothing, right? You have to open up your mouth. You got to have a split sheet ready when you're there doing your production part. Like, you know what? I think I contributed to 10, 15% of this song. Here's the split sheets. I think we should all sign these right now. I always make a video of their song and tag the artist. They 99.9% will repost. Absolutely. Wavy, that's a shirt. Tag your engineer. Tag your engineer. That's a fact. Tag your engineer. LA Rare winner. Let me see. I know y'all. How do you say multi-tracks? I got a video on YouTube. It's a process on how to send your multi-tracks. But basically, if you're working in Pro Tools, just send the whole session. Just send the whole session using the save copy in. Send the session using save copy in. But go to my YouTube channel and watch the step-by-step because I don't want you to miss none of the steps, okay? What's your go-to mixing chain? I don't got no chain on today. Look, that question, I can't really answer that question, okay? My go-to mixing chain, I don't have a go-to mixing chain because I listen and respond to what the music is doing. What's your favorite compressor? Distressor compressor, and also I love the Smack compressor. There's a compressor called Smack. That was Digi Design. Damn, I'm missing a lot of the comments here on Instagram. Damn, I'm using Studio 1.5. It's cool. LA Breadwinner, if you using Studio 1.5, if you sending me the session, you can send me a Studio 1 session. I got all the dogs. You can send me a Studio 1 session. You just got to know export it properly. Or what you can do is it's a long and drawn out process. It's not that hard though, but basically you just need to make 0-point files. So basically render all your files down to be the same length and then export them. Pro Tools for life. That's a fact. Y'all want to see my new Pro Tools tattoo? Coming soon. Coming soon. If y'all help me to get, if I can get up to 50,000 Instagram followers in the next month, I get a Pro Tools tattoo. If I can get 50,000 on my face, I'm gonna get a Pro Tools tattoo on my face. If y'all can do that today, I go get the Pro Tools tattoo on my face if I can get up there today. So let's go. I need y'all to share. Let's go. You ever mix on FL? Bro, you about to get kicked out of the chat. You about to get kicked out the live. Yeah, have I ever mixed on FL? Have you ever cooked on the floor? Oh, man, I'm gonna stop. I ain't drinking enough water today. Oh, Ryan Rose got big badges. My mix is clean on FL. That's what's up. I ain't saying it can't be done. You know, you can rub a couple rocks together and start a fire, but you know what I'm saying? Or you can just go get a lighter. Can we hear a snippet of a track? What track? Let me see. I got a couple new questions over here. Is there any way or place to buy older versions of Antares Auto-Tune, like 5 Evo 8? I feel like those two specifically have a different tone to them. Am I tripping? You might not be tripping. You know, they rewrote the whole software, you know, when they came out with this new stuff. So as far as a place to go and buy those, check the Antares website. They may have some, the archive stuff, you know, like, I forget what you call it, but they might have some legacy products. They might have a page for legacy products that you can buy, or you just might need to go and find some cracks. Find some cracks. Editing on Pro Tools is very fast. Why does your next Pro Tools certification course start in April? It starts in April because it takes about 2 months for us to go through the course together as a unit, which is the way I prefer, so that I can meet up with my students twice a week on live and review with them at the point that they are at. Now, yes, the course is self-paced. You can go through it at your own pace. And if you want to sign up now and not wait, you just won't have the benefit of going through with me and getting that that extra help and extra study sessions along your way through. So if that's something you're interested in, though, you know, because I know some of y'all just want to get the information, you know, get your books. I got the over 20 hours worth of pre-recorded lessons already up. If you're ready to jump in, just go ahead and shoot me a DM and you know, you can get it cracking. The only thing you'll be missing out on is that the twice week live study halls. Okay. You should really tap into more Studio 1-5. It's a lot going on with the mixing and master and pace. Yeah, I know Studio 1 is kind of dope. I know Studio 1 is dope. They got a lot of stuff. I ain't hating on Studio 1. I ain't beat them up in the video yet. Only Pro Tools. Pro Tools was the first DAW that was ever invented, so they all come from that pretty much. That's a fact. Pro Tools is the father. Everybody else is the son. And FL Studio is the Holy Spirit. That's the Holy Trinity. I'm cracking myself up today, man. Yes, if you did open up, you could just come to the live courses in April. But hopefully you'll be certified by then. You'll just go ahead and get your test. If you're interested in registering for anything, link in bio. To sign up for the Wavy Seals Elite, to sign up for the Pro Tools course. It's also, you know, you can check the story. Check this story. Drea vocals in the building. Yeah, I use GarageBand and I'm over it. That's I'm over here on TikTok, clutch as fuck. Say I use GarageBand and I'm over it. Yo, please come and join the Pro Tools, man. My Pro Tools certification course will teach you everything you need to know. Even if you've never opened up Pro Tools before, this will help you get you in the game and be a proficient user of Pro Tools by the time it's all said and done. What are your top three tips for beginners in Logic? Switch to Pro Tools. I'm killing it today. Nah, man, the top three tips for a beginner in Logic, just learn, man. Just learn. It's really it. If you're a beginner at anything, just try to learn and consume as much as you can about it. That's it. But also, switch to Pro Tools. How much is the course? Course is $950 as of today. But the Feds just said that they gonna hold inflation and we right now are at about 6% inflation. So today's price might not be tomorrow's price. It's $950 today. I do got a payment plan that you can sign up on, but tomorrow's price might not be today's price. Inflation is at 6% right now. It's usually at a rate of about 2%. We facing 6% inflation. Everything is going up. Eggs going up. Chicken going up. Gas going up. Rent going up. Pro Tools certification course going up. So go right now to the website, courses.wavywayne.com. I've been a loyal customer for 5 years. I appreciate that. I love that. I appreciate the roses y'all sending over here on TikTok too. Everything is going up, man, as we should, man. We don't want nothing to stay the same. Payment plan is definitely on deck. Does the audio interface or the mic matter more? Good question. I think the song matters most, but I would say that the mic matters more. You can get a $99 Focusrite Scarlett that sounds great, and you can connect it to a great sounding microphone and do some great recordings. But can you go buy a $99 mic and connect it to that $99 interface? man. Technique, you know what? What matters more than the gear? It's going to be the skills, man. Your skills are going to trump any gear that you can get. Exactly. Because if you know what to do to get the sound that you want, you might need to get finagle something here and there. But your skill set is going to matter way more, man. I swear with this inflation, I'm going 120 per hour for recording. Hey, do your thing. You taught me a lot and gave me confidence. Yo, that's what's up. Can we get a Logic course? We in the works. I got this local artist. He had 200K plays on his first album ever posted. Yo, that's lit. But I think definitely you want to get a good mic. You taking on assistant engineers? Not at this time. Unless, never mind. Can we get a Logic course? Okay, here we go. We back over here. Props to Wave, man. It's all about the ear. It's definitely the gear, not the ear, man. It's the skill set, not the tool set. You know, the skill set, not the tool set. You don't got to go spend a whole bunch of money to get great sounding recordings. You don't have to do that. Do you song review? I do. Do you profit more on mixing or recording? Mixing. Wave, what is your resources section to find the Zoom times posted? What are you talking about? You talking about in the Pro Tools course? The resources section, I got to post like the last two Zooms up anyway. So, but yeah, in the resources, then you go to the your certification course, go to the resources. The Zoom times for the classes are Tuesday, 5:30 p.m., Thursday, 10:30 a.m. Central time. Yes, make sure y'all know that's central time. Just in case. So Tuesday, 5:30 p.m. Central time. Thursday, 10:30 a.m. Central time. Okay? The Pro Tools course is enrolling now. Again, we facing 6% inflation. I don't know how long that price is going to stay, the price. So if you're thinking about it, if you're considering it, now is the time to go ahead and sign up, okay? Focusrite or Presonus audio interface. I don't know, cut. Have you been able to use any of your military training to help with any music processes? What make you think I got military training? Because of the Wavy Seals? I have no military training, bro. I don't think. No, that's all a push up. Do you think because I be getting busy with my calisthenics? Well, that ain't come from the military. That's just right here. That's just me versus me. I'm my own commander. I mean, thought I had military training. Nah, I don't. They would kick me out the military. Combat Wavy, that's a fact, man. I'm ready. I'm just, like I said, I'm just suiting up in case any FL gang want to come capping, you know? Anybody in the FL gang want to pull up on me, we can see. Like, I'm really trying to get, I'm trying to see like a, I'm trying to get, like, set up a boxing match with other YouTubers. So, man, if y'all know any other YouTubers, like, call them out and let's see, you know, kind of like, I know Jake Paul, he started on YouTube, right? And then he ended up, you know what I'm saying, fighting, man. So, look. I'm quick. What are your thoughts on Analog Summon? Let's go. I think Analog Summon is it, man. I got the Neve 8816. I think Analog Summon is a major key. Major key. But yeah, man, let's definitely set that up, man. Any YouTubers, any engineers out here want the smoke? Come see me, man. I'm suiting up. I gotta go though. Yeah, I got some mixes I gotta do. I got a couple things I gotta knock out. I appreciate everybody tapping in with me. Yo, if y'all on my Instagram, if you haven't followed me on TikTok yet, please go and do so. Please go and do so. If you on TikTok, if you ain't following my Instagram, please go and do so. It's the same name across both. Bean. It's the same name. I'm out of here. Y'all be dope. Do-do.